February is Black History Month. Black History Month was created to focus attention on the contributions of African Americans to the United States. It honors all Black people from all periods of U.S. history, from being enslaved, from first brought over from Africa in the early 17th century, to African Americans living in the United States today. Today, we have a few of our leaders from our Mosaic and Shades Affinity groups who are going to share with us the origins of Black history, where it comes from, and how we celebrate Black history at Taft. As always, when Mr. Allen stands up here, I ask you to lean into the conversation. Be present. Take something away. Without further ado, I present some of the leaders of Shades and Mosaic.
Good morning, Taft. So before we begin, I would like you all to take a second to look around at each other, look around everyone in this room, acknowledge each other. Please know that the history we are going to be talking about impacts every single person in this room, because Black history is and forever will be part of American history. First, we are going to start with the introduction and origin of Black History Month. It first started February 7th of 1926 by Carter G. Woodson as Negro History Week in order to celebrate some of the accomplishments done by Black people, especially in the United States. This was celebrated at numbers of historically Black colleges and universities, and then was prolonged into a month-long celebration, again, to acknowledge the accomplishments Black people have done for this country as a race and to prove that Black history is part of American history. Again, you may be wondering, all right, I know about Black History Month, but why is it so important? Why do we celebrate it now? To acknowledge the accomplishments Black people have done, especially in the United States, to celebrate and honor people throughout the African diaspora, and to acknowledge all of the systemic racism part of our systems and the people who have done change to change these systems. We have modern everyday technology that we use and don't really think about that have been created by Black people. The modern day traffic light was created by a Black man. Modern day home security system created by a Black woman. And even your modern day toilet was created by a Black man. These are inventions that we use every day and do not think of. Black history is part of American history, and it will forever be part of American history because Black people are part of America.
When we talk about Black history, going off what Jada said, we talk about Black history as well as where we are today, and we celebrate the reflections and celebrations of Black achievement and Black culture, whether that be acknowledging or participating in or sharing our interest in Black entertainment, Black-owned businesses, or in Black history, such as going to the Smithsonian's Museum. When we talk about Black history, it's the history of social change, of social outlook, and of social outreach. We talk about the right to vote. Black men weren't allowed to vote until 1870, and Black men and women fought alongside the rest of the women in the United States for everyone's right to vote up until 1920 with the passing of the 19th Amendment. Today, 12.5% of all nationally registered voters out of 240 million are Black and African American voters. We also look at a social change that have not taken such a positive turn, and the killings of police brutality amongst Black Americans. From all the way back to 1991, with the first recorded police brutality beatings, or what was believed to be the beating of Rodney King on March 3rd, 1991, to July 14th, 2014, the killing of Eric Garner by an illegal chokehold from a police officer that was caught on tape and on film. Yet he died, and none of the officers were discharged. Or, with starts recent protests, almost two summers ago, the killing of George Floyd on May 25th, 2020. But Black history is more than just social change and outreach. and sometimes what we perceive as negative feelings. It's about celebrating Black joy, which is anything that inspires, supports, and uplifts Black culture. Now, whether that be positive pictures, the depiction of family life in the media, such as a wedding or family reunion, it could also be a TV show, such as The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, which some of us all know and love. Black culture goes along with the celebration of cultural icons, people who have used their time in America and their time in their life to help uplift Black people around them, and taking advantage of the full opportunity, such as Oprah Winfrey, who is the first African-American woman to be named a billionaire through her entertainment industries and the OWN network and through philanthropy and being an author. Or Robert L. Johnson, who is the first African-American male billionaire through his entertainment industries endeavors in BET and other entrepreneurial outputs. Or we talk about youngsters such as Caleb Anderson, who is currently the youngest American college student. At 13 years old, he attends the Georgia Institute of Technology, better known as Georgia Tech, where he studies to be an aerospace engineer. Or we talk about LeBron James, a well-known athlete, but also philanthropist, who opened a school for over thousands of kids in his hometown of Akron, Ohio, who now have free tuition to a private school and prepaid college tuition. Or the late, great Chadwick Boseman, who served as an icon for Black children and children across America, depicting Thurgood Marshall, James Brown, and even Jackie Robinson, and most recently with one of his most impactful performances, the portrayal of Black Panther, the first mainstream Black superhero.
Howdy. Oftentimes when we speak on Black history, we talk about it in a national sense. However, there's a lot of Black history where you sit right now at Taft, dating back all the way to after Brown versus Board of Education, which desegregated the United States. So here's this brief timeline here. After 1954, Taft's first African-Black students came to Taft's campus. William Wayne Jackson, who's class of 57, who's from Bermuda, and Wesley Williams, class of 1959, who's from Washington, D.C. Both were heavily involved in the Taft community. William Wayne Jackson was a part of varsity soccer and Orioko's, and Wesley Williams was part of class committee, Orioko's, and many, many, many other things. He also became our first Black trustee and first Black HDT alumni medalist. Then, in 1969, Richard Pierteris became the first Black faculty member at Taft. He was from South Africa and a graduate of Columbia. Then, in 1971 and 1972, the ACT, or the Afro-American Congress at Taft, engaged in walkouts and civic protests to force the school to celebrate MLK Day, which was fully realized in 1977 when Taft held its first MLK Day celebration. Then, in the 1970s, class of 1975, Karen Stevenson became the first Black female student at Taft, and her accomplishments are a lot, so pay attention. She became the first Black woman, Black female Morehead Scholar, the first Black female Rhodes Scholar, the first Black female magistrate judge of California, and is becoming the first Black female, well, first woman of color to become the HDT alumni medalist. Then, in the 1970s and 1990s, a plethora of landmark clubs devoted to diversity, equity, and inclusion came around the Taft campus, such as the ACT, which was previously mentioned in 1970, UCT, which is still going on today, founded in 1982, one of Taft's oldest clubs, and the Afro-Latino Student Alliance in 1990. Finally, in contemporary Taft culture, in 2017, Taft created its DEI statement, formally making it devoted to becoming a diverse, inclusive, and equitable community. And in recent years, there's been many student protests and civic engagement, such as walkouts, such as the 2020 Black Lives Matter walkout at school, and the Black Hat Pages instigated by the murder of George Floyd and our nation's racial awakening, reawakening. This included the Black at Taft Instagram account, which highlighted Black students and alumni's experience at the Taft School. Then you also have just a brief images here, such as Wesley Williams on his tennis team at Taft, the Black at Taft Instagram, our first Black head monitor, Hank Torbert, class of 1990, the Taft walkout in 2020, Karen Stevenson speaking here in 2018, the ACT walkout in 1971, some student sit-ins circa 2016, and our first Black faculty, Richard Pierre Therese.
Sorry. All right, so next we're gonna look at some clubs that highlight the Black experience at Taft. So Ronald mentioned some of these earlier, but we have the Afro-American Congress at Taft, which was the first club that highlighted the Black experience. That was created in 1970, and you can see a visual representation of them on the right. Next we have UCT, or United Cultures at Taft, which was created in 1982, and it's one of the oldest clubs here at Taft. It still is around today, so that's pretty impressive in itself. Next, we have the Afro-Latino Student Alliance, which was created in 1990. The Black Alliance Club, which was created in 2020. Shades and Mosaics, the Afro-American Congress at Taft was developed into Shades and Mosaics eventually. And then we have Somos Taft, which was created in 2021, and African Students Affinity. And these clubs and these affinity groups and alliance groups are created not only just to highlight the Black experience for non-Black students here at Taft, but also to affirm and validate those students' feelings that are a part of those groups and those members, community members, excuse me, in themselves. We come together to create these spaces to make ourselves feel comfortable and also just to have a space where we can all look around and acknowledge each other's presence and acknowledge how we affect the community around us. So what does Taft look like now? We have the mission statements of many of these different alliance groups and affinity groups. Shades is an affinity group created to bring together Black and Latinx men under the goals of charity, brotherhood, and promoting cultural diversity at Taft and beyond. Mosaic is an affinity group that provides a safe space for Black and Latinx women to feel comfortable, loved, and empowered. And the Black Alliance Club is a student organization set on creating productive conversations about race at a predominantly white school slash institution. And here we have some pictures of the BIPOC faculty and Shades and Mosaic members. Some statistics for you all. The diversity in faculty increased from 9% in 2020 to 15% as of 2022. And we also have a note about admissions, which is a book written by Kendra James. She was the first Black legacy here at Taft, and she graduated in the class of 05. And her book came out, I believe, January 18th, so not that long ago. You should all go check that out. And then, of course, the Black at Taft Instagram, which was mentioned earlier, that highlights the Black experience from classes before and current classes today. So this is the last slide, but next we are going to look at a video that was created by Drew Nowinski, so shout out to him. And this is going to be some of your Shades and Mosaics members, as well as Black faculty, Black staff here on campus, talking about Black History Month, what it means to them, and what being Black at Taft does mean to them. So thank you all.
So while we're waiting to figure out about the video, here, let me just kind of let everybody know some things that are getting ready to happen on campus related to our Black History Month programming. So this Thursday, I sent out an email yesterday, just want to let everybody know that we will be back here again in Bingham during IBLOC. We're going to have a guest speaker. Dr. Rydell Harrison is going to come and speak to us. He was the former superintendent of Watertown Public Schools, also of ER9 down in Reading, Easton, here in Connecticut. He now is doing some other things, and we're really excited to have him. Also next week, we are going to have, Mr. Khalil Green, who is a graduate of Yale University. He actually graduated in 2019, and he holds the distinction of being the first African-American student body president in Yale history. And so we're really excited about having him come and speak to you all about his experiences and what that looks like. Thank you, Reggie. Reverend Dr. Jackie Lewis.
Jackie Lewis from the oldest church in America, New York City, really diverse church, and she wrote a book, Fierce Love, involved in revolutionary love. Another African American person you probably
Okay, so a couple quick programming points. We're ready for the video. Thank you.
Black History Month is important to me because we can appreciate the contributions of Black people from different parts of the African diaspora.
To me, Black History Month means celebrating the courage of my ancestors with family gatherings, food, and by acknowledging and appreciating the privileges that I have today.
Black History Month, to me, is a time for everybody to come together to celebrate what Blacks have been able to do over the years and for people to appreciate what they have done for us.
So growing up, for me, Black History Month, when I was a young child, meant that my mom would get out these little Black History Month cards that she had in our house and little Black History Month books. And it was something that was very personal and private to my home, but also this stark reminder of the education I wasn't getting outside of my home.
What does Black History Month mean to me? I think Black History Month is a month of awareness. A month that allows people who might not identify as African-American to really spare some thought to the plight and disadvantages of their fellow citizens.
Hi, my name is Jasmine Pun, and to me, Black History Month means celebrating my family and my community, and also means to me about how we acknowledge the history of Black people and how it affects today's life.
Hello, my name is Karan Karana Parks, and Black History Month means to me the celebration of Black excellence and joy.
Thank you all for the opportunity that you have all given me to be able to express myself as a Black person. I don't think we've ever had this kind of inclusion, and I'm grateful and I'm happy to be part of this movement here at the Taft School. This is great in many ways to be part of something that, you know, our young people have started, and it will carry on to the next generation and the next generation.
To us, Black History Month means appreciating Black culture,
Black excellence and history.
Black History Month to me means the continuation of learning about our history and also the opportunity to teach people about our culture.
To me, Black History Month is about celebrating the African diaspora and appreciating the people who struggled before us to bring us the life we have now.
And to me, Black History Month is about acknowledging the struggles that we've been through and everybody who worked to overcome that, but it's also about Black joy, because Black life is beautiful and I feel that more people should see that.
Good morning, everyone. Most of you know me as Ms. G in the college office, and as is self-explanatory, I am an African-American, and I would like to say that I celebrate Black history every single day. I live it, breathe it, and know it, and I invite you to join in the celebration of Black history.
For me, growing up, there really was no, you know, Black History Month. In school, it'd just be like, let's watch a movie at home about Black History Month, so it was just another day off in school. So coming to Taft and having at least something, even something small happening for Black History Month, it was all new to me. So what I've discovered through my years at Taft and celebrating Black History Month is that that really is what it is. It's a celebration, and it's not always about, you know, slavery and racism and the struggle. It's about the people who struggled before us to create more Black joy for today and for us to be able to celebrate because of those people in the past.
Black History Month highlights the contributions of Black culture.
Black culture inspires us to learn about one another and celebrate each other.
To me, Black History Month is a celebration of joy and the contributions that Black people have made to not only American society, but the world in general.
To me, Black History means standing up to the status quo, calling out things that aren't right, and shamelessly expressing my identity, especially in this community.
Black History Month to me is a celebration of culture. It embodies a time when we weren't able to have the opportunities to go to a school like this. And so I think this month is just about like being your best self.
To me, Black History Month is a time when we acknowledge Black people for all the great things they did in this country.
Happy Black History Month, y'all.
Happy
Happy Black History Month.
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 Happy Black History Month.